let's come back to these kind of errors, random and systematic. Okay, now tell me what could be the example of systematic error.
Yeah, no, it'll have precision, but lack of accuracy. Yeah.
What could be, so you are using an instrument to measure something. Suppose you are measuring length using vernier caliper. What could be the systematic error?
See,
the definition of systematic is this. Systematic errors are the error which you can remove systematically. Using step-by-step manner, if you perform the experiment, you can remove the systematic error. That is the definition of systematic error. Okay? Now, can you give me examples of it?
Zero error.
Okay? Write down zero error. Parallax error. Okay, parallax error. What else? Suppose you are angry all the time. Okay, even that can cause the error. Systematic error. So there will be a step, don't be angry, right?
So won't that be random?
No, if you are angry, if you are angry, then probably you have this habit of measuring the smaller length slightly more when you are angry.
So what if you're suddenly angry?
Somebody slapped you.
That's that.
Okay, so there can be many systematic errors. There can be like, you know, there are some... Okay. In your textbook, it is systematically written, these systematic errors. There are three parts of the systematic error. Write down instrumental error. Second part, imperfect experimental procedure. And third one is the personal error. You have personal bias. Okay, so instrumental error we already discussed. They are, write down, zero error. They are like zero, for example, zero errors. Zero error is the example of instrumental error. Okay, suppose you have an instrument, okay, which always, you know that it is giving faulty readings. Okay, so systematic error. So how you should remove that? Replace the instrument. Are you getting it? So it's a systematic error, which you can correct it by changing the instrument itself. Or if you know that there is a zero error, how much is zero error? You can just calibrate it.
Also like wire heating up in the electrical experiment.
Wire heating up in the electrical experiment. Suppose your room is having high temperature. Okay. And somehow you are inside the room alive and doing the experiment, everything will get expanded. Are you getting it? So the step will be conduct this experiment at 35 or 30 degrees, less than 30 degrees Celsius, like that. That could be the step to remove that error. So there, the every systematic error has a step to remove it. Fine? So this is instrumental error. Imperfect procedure. What could be the example of imperfect?
Parallax error.
You have this habit of looking things like that, so there will be parallax error. Getting it? You have this habit of looking from one eye, close the other eye. So we have just seen, right? The object moves. Object shifts. So we need to remove that. So what could be the step of that? Look from both the eyes. Look from the above. Like that. So That is why these steps of conducting experiments are there in your lab records. Personal errors. Suppose you're doing the experiment with your enemy. You'll fight. So step could be, don't do the experiment with your enemy. I mean, it may sound like a very funny thing, but there, you know, these things are, they can cause the error. Okay? So personal error could be anything. We humans are very complicated. It could be any damn thing. In fact, imperfect procedure or experimental condition, the parallax error is personal error. By the way, it's not procedure, it's a personal error. I think we have said parallax is imperfect procedure. No, it is from the personal point of view, how you conduct the experiment can cause a personal error. Okay, imperfect procedure could be if you are conducting the experiment at 100 degrees Celsius, but it should be conducted at 20 degrees Celsius. That is imperfect procedure. But whatever is the error arising from your personal, the way you are conducting experiment, is the personal error. Getting it? Personal error should be independent of what is the instrument, how you are tightening it, and things like that. Personal error should be only you to blame. Random error. Random errors, write down, random errors are the errors which cannot be removed. Random errors cannot be removed. These can arise, write down, these errors can arise due to, these errors can arise due to random and unpredictable, due to random and unpredictable fluctuations in experimental conditions. Getting it?
Yeah.
These errors can arise due to random and unpredictable fluctuations in the experimental conditions. Okay, what could be these fluctuations? Fluctuation in
power,
voltage, fluctuation in voltage. You cannot calculate how much fluctuation. It's a random thing. There can be some, there can be wind that suddenly starts blowing. You're getting it? That can cause random error. Right? So any random event can cause the random error, which you cannot quantify how much is the error. And you cannot have a step to remove these errors. Alright, so that, give me a few examples. There are not many examples. One is random fluctuation in voltage. What could be the other example?
Wind.
Wind and all that fluctuation in the experimental condition. Random fluctuation in experimental condition. You can say that I will take care of fluctuations by using a better voltage source and things like that. Okay, but you'll never be able to eliminate it. That's what my point is. You can minimize it, but you can't make it zero. Okay, you'll say that, okay, I'll conduct the experiment in a vacuum chamber. Okay, but perfect vacuum can't be achieved. Getting it? Similarly, you can say that I use a constant voltage source. What if one electron which is traveling in the wire starts moving randomly because of whatever reason? It collided inside with another nucleus inside the wire and it is not moving as per what you want it to be. It is random. Okay, you cannot make sure that electron dodges each and every atom inside the wire. It will get collided. Okay, so you cannot remove these errors, you can just minimize it. Minimizing means you are managing them. Okay, what else? What do you think? other error could be random. Random error. Earthquake. There is an earthquake. You are in the middle of experiment. You will continue doing experiment. I like, okay, I'll conduct the experiment. Then only I'll die.
You know, so like, what if it's very small and you were doing some experiment with a pendulum or something?
Yeah, correct. So that's what
that
it is. Random fluctuation in experiment.
That comes under fluctuation only.
Okay, there. When you, why you have screw gauge and vernier caliper both to measure the length? Why can't you just use vernier caliper, not the screw gauge?
The scale is smaller.
Okay, the normal scale you have, can you measure more than 1 mm, less than 1 mm using that? You cannot. You can say, you know, you can roughly say though, you can say that this is 1 mm, so if my length is here somewhere, I'll say that it is 0.45. I can argue, why not 0.44? Are you getting it? So you are never sure if it is 0.4 or 0.5. You can say it is between 0.4 and 0.5. Okay? But accuracy or precision is not there. Less than 1 mm. Less than 1 mm accuracy is not there in your scale. Are you getting it? So there is an error in the second decimal point. Yes or no? Right? You don't know when you say 0.44, you don't know whether it is 0.47, 0.43, 0.45. There is uncertainty in the second decimal place. Okay? So this is random error. Because of the nature of instrument itself. The instrument which you are using is not accurate enough to give you the true reading.
So isn't that systematic?
It's not systematic. Because you cannot remove it. You can use a different instrument. Suppose rather using scale, you say, okay, I'll use vernier caliper. Vernier caliper has accuracy till second decimal point. Now third decimal point has error. Getting it? Then you say, I'll use screw gauge till 3 decimal point, but the 4th decimal point has error. You cannot eliminate it. Understood? And you can't even quantify it. Here you can quantify how much is the error. Imperfect procedure or instrument error, you know exactly how much is a zero error. Zero error is 1 mm, so you will take into account of 1 mm. But if I say the random error is 1 mm, you don't know whether you have to add or subtract. Are you getting it? These are random error. It could be both sides. You don't know. Fine? So, this is called least count error. Write down. So, even for some means, you remove the random fluctuation. Suppose you are somewhere where there is no fluctuation in anything. Okay, but you can never remove least count error. Never ever. Okay, so this is the kind of random error which we need to manage. This least count error we must manage. All these can be eliminated. Okay, but then we need to manage least count error. For example, if I measure the length. Okay, if I measure the length, let's say 0.4 meter with a device which can only measure up to first decimal point. Okay, so what I'll say my measurement is lying between 0.4 plus minus 0.1 meters. Are you getting it? There's an error.
Yeah.
It can be it is definitely more than 0.3. But less than
0.5.
Okay, so it is one thing to talk about number. Okay, when I have to say some number, okay, for example, let's say pi has a fixed value, no error. Why? Because you have not measured it. It's a constant. Pi is a constant. fixed value, no error. 2 is a number which is a constant. You have not measured it. No error. But if you are measuring something, let's say I'm measuring length, I'm measuring mass, time, every measurement has at least this one, this error, least count error, which you cannot remove. Okay? Alright? That is why you have these instruments, more accurate and accurate instrument, like vernier caliper is there, screw gauge is there. There are instruments which measure more accuracy than screw gauge also. They are probably up to 4 places of their decimal it is accurate. But 5th decimal place is not accurate. Okay? So there is a difference between this reading, 2.000 meter, and if I say 2.0 meter, there is a difference between these two. This is accurate up to 3 decimal place. This is accurate only first. The way you write, there's a difference. Okay?